as always, the flow of our genetic information moves from DNA to RNA and then RNA to protein. And we've already talked about how the DNA or adenovirus viral vector vaccines work and how the mRNA vaccines work. But now another company called Novavax is designing a protein-based vaccine that of course comes in at the protein level against SARS-CoV-2. Now this technology has been used in the past against other vaccines such as for HPV. But the SARS-CoV-2 has 29 proteins, but the protein of interest is that spike protein on the outside of the virus that we want to create immunity against. So what Novavax did is they isolated out the genetic material that encodes for that single spike protein. So it's only one of these 29 proteins found in SARS-CoV-2. They then took that genetic material and mixed it with another virus called a baculovirus. Now, this baculovirus now contains the genetic material to make the spike protein. They can then take that modified baculovirus and infect it into moth cells. So no human cells were used in this manufacturing. Now, the baculovirus can then replicate inside the moth cells, creating more of itself. But what it also does is it creates that spike protein, which it doesn't need. So what we can do is isolate out that spike protein found in the moth cells and then use that isolated out spike protein as a vaccine. When it's used as a vaccine, our body sees this spike protein and recognizes it as foreign, elicits an immune response, and then destroys it and has memory against it for any future infections. But what this vaccine also contains is a compound found from bark trees that's able to serve as an extra signal to our immune system, increasing the amount of B and T cells that come to the area. This allows for an extra boost of memory and antibodies produced in case SARS-CoV-2 infects your body in the future. You're able to recognize that spike protein and destroy the virus before it has a chance to cause you harm.